reaction of the team knowing that what happened a couple days ago with your head coach and your GM being fired?
I think we're just – everybody's, you know, just ready to move forward. You know, we don't put too much emphasis on what happened. I'm really thankful for the time that I had with Coach Chamberlain. He gave me an opportunity when no one would. And I'm very grateful for that. I'm happy that I was able to talk to him before he left. But it's a business, and it's something that everybody, you know, the task at hand is to win this weekend. So that's what everybody's mindset is.
Can you share that conversation or not?
We just basically, kind of just talked about, you know, how I told him that I appreciated, you know, the opportunity. You know, we just talked through the decision and stuff like that. It was a really good conversation though, and it's something that like I said, I'm really thankful that I had with him.
The changes moving forward, even in practice we saw music blaring. Did you find that helped to kind of maybe get a little bit of a lightheartedness in practice?
Yeah, it was a little different. We haven't experienced that. It was something that I think everybody was surprised to hear coming out to practice and having the music blast, and it was pretty cool. I thought that raised the energy level.
Hey, Tearrius, kind of a new era dawning today in Saskatchewan, I guess. First, just your thoughts on everything that's transpired over the last 24 to 48 hours.
It's a part of the business. I mean, we all know, you know, stuff like that happens, whether you're a player, coach, GM, or whatnot. But I just guess we got to find a way to pick up and move on the best way we can.
Is it almost, it's when a coach gets fired, it's an indictment on the entire team, is it not? Because you can't get rid of everyone, so you have to change something, and it usually ends up being the guy at the top.
True. I mean, again, those decisions that the board and those guys feel that they need to make, and we just got to go along with them.
I don't know. I mean, I still feel bad for the two guys that were let go. I mean, Coach Chain was great to me in the 4 years he was the head coach, and obviously my relationship with Mr. Tamman goes way deep. He brought me into the league, and he brought me back here, and it's obviously definitely a time of change.
Is there some excitement with Bob and Jeremy now doing the job or not?
Yeah, I mean, I've been with Coach Dyce for a long time too, and I think in terms of what Jeremy's played and, you know, played the position being a Canadian O-lineman, I feel like we got a lot in common, and hopefully that that common ground will be the basis of our relationship growing. But it's definitely a different time when some of the guys that you've known best throughout your whole career are no longer with you.